DriveWorks is a powerful automation tool for SolidWorks. But without the proper training, it can be a challenge to model efficiently and make the best use of the tool. As experienced DriveWorks users, we've experienced a wide range of emotion while designing our models and rules. Over the years, we've developed techniques that can help you to save time and reduce those stress levels, saving you bags of hard-earned cash in the process. So, here's the ultimate way to use DriveWorks to effectively automate your processes and reduce your design time. You can thank us later in the comments and by subscribing. Templates will always save you time. And with DriveWorks, it's important to have a standard set of templates to use specifically for DriveWorks. This ensures that all models have the same custom properties, settings, units, and predefined features, such as planes or folder systems if you use them. If you want to learn how to create custom templates, then book onto our DriveWorks training course and enhance your skills. You also need to future-proof your designs by considering how the model might change in the future with DriveWorks. When modeling, you need to make sure that your model is robust, so change key dimensions at various points throughout the modeling process to ensure that the model can hold up to such changes. That way, you don't have to worry about your model exploding after you've already automated everything. Logical and consistent part orientations make things easier for you down the line. To stay consistent with your decisions is a surefire way to help anyone else who needs to work with the model. And speaking of consistency, keeping a logical and consistent origin position is a game changer. This will allow you to make use of symmetry using the standard planes and helps with mating up components further down the line, as the three standard planes will always be in the same place relative to the model. It also means you don't need as many rules to drive your model. It's worthwhile naming key features, sketches, and dimensions as you go. This makes capturing the part easier, as the name will autofill. As a bonus tip, always make sure that all captured information is named sensibly, as this will make rule writing easier further down the line. To help you with this, turn on the SolidWorks system option to automatically name features on creation. KSS. Keep sketches simple. That applies both to sketch geometry and the plane on which they exist. By limiting your sketches to the three standard planes as much as possible, you avoid unnecessary planes and overcomplicating the model. Avoid sketching on faces that could change, as this can cause references to be lost. The same goes for mates in assemblies. Be sure that you're mating to standard planes or faces that won't change or be removed by modeling further down the line. As a general rule of thumb, sketch on planes rather than faces. Always ensure that your sketches are fully defined. This is the key takeaway from our SolidWorks Essentials training course. Additionally, when defining sketches, be sure to use relations to constrain the sketch as much as possible before you add dimensions. This promotes change and bakes design intent into the model. If you struggle to remember to always fully define your sketch, there is a setting in the system options to force you to do this. It's also wise to avoid in-context modelling, equations, design tables, and sketch patterns. All of these features encourage automation, but that's why we have DriveWorks. Let DriveWorks do the automating, as this keeps all the logic in one place. Otherwise, these methods may conflict with one another. Before we get on to our number one tip though, be sure to subscribe and leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Don't miss out on a great opportunity to improve your DriveWorks skills with our specialised training courses. You can find a classroom near you or attend online. And there's a whole host of courses to choose between, from SolidWorks to CATIA, rendering and simulation. Or if you can't choose, then get yourself a SolidWorks passport to become a SolidWorks expert. Anyway, we've let the tension build long enough, so here's our number one tip on your way to ultimate DriveWorks efficiency. Mating to coordinate systems is an effective way of generatively inserting components into your assemblies. Position coordinate systems in sensible locations on your master models. This is useful for inserting components using generation tasks, as you can fully define a component's position using a singular insert coordinate system mate task. And this prevents the master model from being overloaded and speeds up generation time. As we've said before, you need to make sure that these are named consistently. So really, that's the ultimate way of working in DriveWorks to effectively automate your design processes. Don't forget to let us know in the comments what other countdowns you'd like to see in future, and tell us what tips you couldn't live without. Be sure to check out our SolidWorks tutorials across our website and subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay up to date with all the latest SolidWorks offers, tutorials, and solutions.